Hi, and welcome back to Let's Win XCOM Long War. I'm Phwop, and this is my Project Nemesis series. So, we had a tough mission last time. I've been complaining about how easy the game was, and then I got pincered on a terror map for an abduction by mutons and thin men, and we lost a young specialist rocketeer. Unfortunately, my rocketeer seemed to be fairly short-lived. At least he was young, and we hadn't invested a ton of experience in him, but it is always sad to see good talent go, and we will once again have to raise another rocketeer up from the ranks. The massive number of explosives, because we did bring two rocketeers in that mission, were the only thing that allowed us to hold out, and we didn't get much for it except not losing. Thanks to our very tough scout and assault, we were able to hold off the pincer formation while our snipers did the dirty work. But only because we knew it was a roadway mission did we bring that many snipers and rocketeers, and we just lucked out. Oh, look at these clouds just peacefully drifting at 1,000 miles per hour across the Earth. Alright, so the good news is we've got full coverage of Europe, which means we're going to be getting 20% increased funding. We can check officer training school because we are totally ready. Officer training perks will now have a reduced rank requirement, so thanks to taking over the United Kingdom. We, of course, infantry and assault have +1 health. France, our starting bonus country item requests occur 40% faster. Fulfilled requests provide 40 additional defense. Intel scans 40% less. Germany, 15% reduction in cash, alloy, and lyrium required for mech and shiv primary weapons. And then we're going to be moving into Asia. 34% bonus cash from alien corpse and wreck sales. That might be worth it. +2 aim for new shiv and mech troopers. Okay. 5% research bonus for each lab adjacency. +2 bonus aim for newly promoted gunners and racketeers. Both fine choices. What we're going for is this 25% foundry bonus. We'd like to get that up as soon as possible since we will have a foundry in a week. Okay, in other news, we've got coming up covert operation in 3 days. There's nothing we're going to be able to do to improve our tactical situation before then. But of course, that's when the operation triggers, and then you have a certain amount of time to hit that operation. And we do have plenty of troops ready to go out. We are 4 people down, despite gaining 3 bonus troops over the course of the game. We have had significant losses in the memorial. We've lost 4 specialists, a private, a lance corporal, and ouch, a corporal rocketeer with 18 kills. So things have been a little tough. But at the end of this month, we will have the cash to pay for these advanced beam lasers. I believe we've been stocking up the resources. And these laser rifles, I would love to... How much is it going to cost me to build 3 laser rifles right now? This is how much a corporal costs. 114 cash, which is exactly how much I have, and 24 alloys. What did Chin say? Commander, what you got in your wallet? Yeah, that'll be enough. I'm tempted to go for it. How long will that take? 11 days. Okay, I'm going for it. That was a little bit of a misclick, but hey. Alright, so we're gonna make this trade and we're gonna get a Rocketeer out of it. And then we'll have a Corporal Rocketeer to replace the Rocketeers we've been, you know, losing. Because, of course, we can select his class. So that'll be awesome. First, we're gonna go on this covert op. Right? 62 hours. Maybe we're not. No, the request from Europe's totally gonna hang first. Okay. Well, we're gonna edge. Yes, I desperately need engineers. And the more defense around the world, the better. Watching that timer on the request from Europe. Yes, I need scientists too. Alright, looks like no mission is gonna pop up. Just trade these right now. Russia's better able to defend itself, great. And we get a brand new corporal for 114. Yep. Let's see. Good movement. Health. Okay defense. Slow aim. I could go. What are the other Rocketeers I have? I have a Vandal. And we've got Doomsday Boy. We've got a hammer. Low aim is actually better suited to the longbow. It may seem incongruous, but javelin rockets gives you incredible aim at medium distances, because it just stretches out by about 50% the aim loss. So it lets you fire rockets at moderate range, the standard rocket max, with incredible accuracy, despite having relatively low accuracy. Whereas the hammer, if your accuracy is too poor, you're gonna end up hitting yourself because the explosion is so big. With these smaller rockets, with the extended range of javelin, you're gonna be just fine with a little bit of a subpar aim. And our choices here, if you're gonna go all offense, no defense, you can skimp on low profile. You have noted that my Rocketeers tend to die, so I'm not totally into that. Fire in the hole and snapshot are kind of worthless together. It does make for a really well-rounded soldier who can always fire fairly accurately, but when you take javelin rockets, you can move and shoot with great accuracy at even middle to long rocket range, thanks to snapshot. So I'm gonna go with these two aren't actually very beneficial. Sapper, now that you can take HE grenades to give your rockets heat, or HE charges, Sapper is a little more viable if you plan on doing that all the time, but it is not necessary, just because you'll have those grenades with you, not because it helps with your rockets in any way. Although your rockets will be completely annihilating the environment wherever they land. I might just go for that, despite my Rocketeers all dying far too soon. Destroying cover is so good. Rockets do a buttload of cover damage, even the basic ones. But this will guarantee that they just annihilate that cover. No, let's go with defense. Play it safe. Alright, a little desperate getting rid of my laser rifles, but The regular rifles are no slouch.
Contact detected.
Alright, scout class UFO, do I have something with avalanches? Oh, the Phoenix cannon. Let's send out this rookie with the avalanche cannons. Save the Phoenix can for something bigger. Or save the Phoenix can for finishing this guy off. That was a nice intercept. Alright, carefully watching the health. Not looking at anything else. That was beautiful. Have we not named that guy yet? Giggles Mitchell. Wildcat Spain. Wrong way right. Yes, please. Alright, way to score a kill first time out. That was a beautiful thing. Okay, we're gonna see how this covert op is gonna stack against this crash site first. Yes, more scientists is good. Okay, let's look at how long covert operation, 48 hours left to assault it. Let's see how this goes. Protect the intel asset by eliminating all exalt forces in the area of operation. Data recovery. So we're gonna get a full-size squad, urban close quarters. This is gonna be an intense fight. It would have been nice to have the laser rifles with us. But rockets will also be useful. This is going to be kind of intense. What's the timer left on the crash site? 22 hours. Okay, since we have two missions right on top of each other, what I'm actually going to do is exhaust some people for one of them. Let's exhaust some after. So here's the logic. I send people. I now know how many people I need to send on this covert operation. Covert operation is more important because it also, the life of our soldier that we sent out is in the hands of this team. If anyone got, so you have two missions. The first mission, you can take anyone you have available. The second mission, you can take anyone who wasn't wounded in the first mission by exhausting them. So, the most important mission, you go on first, in case someone important gets wounded and can't go on the next mission. If no one gets wounded, you can just exhaust everyone to go out on that second mission. So, that's what we're gonna do. This mission's more important, we pick our A team. Maybe we'll exhaust one of these officers. I'm gonna take both, I think. Okay, I want close encounters, holo targeting, explosives for exposing people. You want lots of attacks. Snipers let you move faster if they're kind of mobile. Rockets are great. I want a scout. I want a fast scout. Do we have a faster scout? fast, but you're not a forward scout. Battle scanner, actually fairly good. We can make this scout fast. Shotguns really help you get mobile. That will up our defense and resistances without slowing us down quite as much. And we will be sacrificing some grenades. Urban close quarters. Note if I just modify my weapon, I can go quite light. If I just take two grenades, rely on will to survive, low profile, decent armor, tact sense, lightning reflexes to keep me safe. We make this slower, tougher scout faster. Alright, here we've got a Harrier sniper, snapshot, hit and run. Squad sight lets us use the full-size sniper rifle. Do want to nail our shots. Too slow. So let's see, we've got three shots from here. Extended magazines never really hurts. And there are always a lot of enemies. Let's come back to whether I want that armor. Think I might. It does slow us down a little bit. Here, what do we got? That light machine gun, so good. Try and make sure he's ready for the next mission, though that will slow him down significantly. Maybe we should just give him the junction beam cannon. Because he'll be sprinting either way. Second, real life calls. I have to send someone a phone number. Do. All right, so close quarters, close encounters, I mean, bioelectric skin, muscle fiber density, all these things are going to make for a sick mobile unit. We do want her to be as speedy as possible. Tough. In this case, we are bringing a lot of explosives, so let's actually focus on sheer beastly toughness. yeah. So, brute toughness here. That's a lot of tough. Here. Want some HE charges. That'll help give our rockets the ability to clear out all things explosive-y. And I'm gonna bring an additional rocket. Let's go with the reflex rack. And armor. I can't believe that soldier is so fast. Shilong has hit and run, is on the assault team. We're going to be bringing the heavy ballistics rack, I believe. Bastion rigging. Scope to cancel out the occasional heavy ballistics penalty. And then our longbow here. Be gifted with a shatter beam array. And all the rockets in the world. Alright, so we've got a full load. Lots of goodies. Lots of explosives, because there are a ton of people. Now, you can blow up the transmitter, and you do lose money if you do that, so don't do that. Let's check out our weapon mix. Two shotguns, some lasery weapons. Remember, we're bringing the junction beam cannon. Does have great aim and rapid fire. Extended mags to make that work better. Ready for anything. Gonna be so slow. That's where we're bringing the junction beam cannon. He's basically going to have to dash whenever he moves positions anyway, so we might as well give him the heavy weapon. Plus, holo targeting doesn't overlap. He does get rapid fire, so we'll see how it works. His area suppression could really be key. You know what? Damn it. I'm just bringing this. It's a little bit faster, and it's got a lot more ammo. And that area suppression holo targeting is going to be sick. Alright, so let's go. What I really wish I had was enhanced or rangefinder extensions. Strike the one. Plus 2 ballistic damage weapons. You can really use that to bridge the gap before you have a lot of laser weapons. But I don't have a foundry up yet. All you need is a foundry and alien materials, I think, to get that. And I kind of wish it was easier. I'll have to try that. I'm going to have to try foundry before beam sometime.
Our operative was in position to transmit the data they'd acquired.
Okay, so this is going to make a great killing field for us.
The encoder is currently shielding our transmitter's position.
The problem is, there's some heavy cover down there. We're going to have to flank.
If they had both, any hope we had of recovering the data intact will be lost.
Thankfully, our covert operative starts out close to us. Let's remind ourselves what our covert operative has. Alloy matrix plating, extra conditioning, will to survive, bastion, yep, okay. So we've got a nice, tough, running gun assault, ready to go. How do we want to roll? I think we want to flank these heavy positions inside the green zone from the left. So I'd like to storm this building, which also gives us good cover as we move towards it, and hold this building as well. Our operative can swing out. We can support with snipers, maybe a rocket over here. And most of our guns can move this way and hole up right here on the corner. So we have to move pretty fast, even though we have some view of that, because let's see the encoder. Which one's the encoder? Does it say? Doesn't say. Let's go with the encoder. We have two turns to protect. Oh yeah. And the transmitter is three. So, we definitely want to move fast. No one brought battle scanners, but battle scanners. So we have three heavy weapons, rockets and snipers. The light machine gun shifts between heavy and light, depending. Fortunately, this isn't a very mobility-based map, so he's not going to get left behind too far. Remember, it said urban close quarters. We got a lot of grenades. We're going to start off with... these are worth moving in on. How many of those are there? So we can dash our sniper up there. With a running gun, we can disable their weapons pretty much immediately. And the question is it worth it for us to buy one turn to get into position, perfectly positioned, where all they can do is like rocket us? The answer is probably yes, so you just have to go hard on these exalt missions. Though it feels so risky. Alright, before we decide to do that, let's see if we can get away with dashing.
We finally have a visual confirmation of Exalt's operatives in the field, and from the looks of them, Exalt is working quickly to integrate alien genetic material into their troops. Until we know the extent of their capabilities, I would advise extreme caution.
Commander, Exalt forces are in position to hack the encoder. If we don't secure that equipment, they'll be able to locate the transmitter.
Well, that answers that. We are going in very hard. The shotgunner is going to take the brunt of securing this room. With close encounters and running gun from the shotgun, we have plenty of options. You can't use both at the same time. Plus, remember, this character won't panic. We're going to need to get someone down into that segment down there. And position our rockets. Now, those basic troops do have grenades. They will feel pretty free to use them. She might actually be able to get off a grenade. We didn't bring smoke.
Got it. Moving.
Okay, let's get our sniper up there. See if that triggers any enemies. Light machine guns do have maximized range, that is, they can fight at extended ranges. So do heavy ballistics weapons, so we should be able to take a shot at this guy. We do have hit and run, so we should be able to get a free shot at him from here.
On task.
If we can see him. If we drop this grenade. And trust me, you want to thin their ranks as fast as possible.
Eat this.
Got him.
There's hit and run. Can't get too far. Let's wait. Let's run and gun. Should get a flank shot on this guy down here. Can't miss. Does not crit, so we don't get a ton of damage.
Got it.
Ah.
Coordinates. Я уже там.
I don't think I need just yet to burn my running gun. So I've only got two shots here. I'm just gonna hunker my agent. Okay, we gotta get someone down in here. Ouch! This guy. Wow. Wow, accurate. So we get clipped. Doesn't go through Van Dorn's armor. Does get into our rocketeers. We get hit and run, and of course once we move, we're gonna be a little less accurate.
Roger. Traction.
No one went into Overwatch.
Looks like Exalt deployed a series of communications relays in the area. If our operative can get close enough and access the relay using the encryption keys they acquired from Exalt's data, they should be able to temporarily disrupt the enemy's comm network. Enemy communications are down.
We are going to disable them for a while. This time. Now that should be a flank here for Xilong, so we're going to take that instead, I think. This poor guy wounded. Shredder should not have a problem hitting all these guys. Even with our horrific scatter. Well, okay, not true. Okay, sniper's in a great place, especially with that damn good ground perk.
Heading there now. Weapons hot.
We activate that pod. Too bad they're not shredded. Do the damage with a heavy battle rifle. We need someone down there, some ones perhaps. Not many people better than our running gun sniper. Now our chances to hit are incredible because we have damn good ground, thanks to the sniper. We also have hit and run. But we're fighting a little close, so let's just use our hit and run.
Hostile pacified.
That guy can be suppressed.
Enemy is back.
This one is one of our toughest. So we're gonna block this hacking. Put down some threatening Overwatch. Not a bad shot.
On my way.
Let's see if our Vandal can make it any easier. Okay, we do have Sapper. We'd love to destroy some of their cover. Maybe we can end this guy. Now it looks like we'll be able to dash down there if we need to, so let's go ahead and take a shot here. Make this guy a little more nervous. Thank you. Maybe we can pick this guy off with a lucky hit. I'm gonna get my scout down here, and this guy is being suppressed. We're gonna take a chunk out of. Small chunk. If he tries to move, he's likely to die to our opportunist. This guy also should have trouble. 62% shotgun shot. Misses somehow. Still, he's heavily wounded. Has to reload. Thankfully, he didn't go for a grenade. Okay, they're getting really aggressive up in here.
Commander, we've got multiple hostiles inbound on Strike One's position.
They're coming in.
Reinforcements are closing in.
Oh, I see. He had to get away from the exploding thing. Okay, we have some great shots here. Pretty much guaranteed a crit against this guy. We are actually guaranteed a crit. Will I need to use my officer perk? Maybe not. Remember, these guys have not yet reloaded. These ones out in the open are people back up here can handle. It's the other ones I'm a little concerned about. Make sure we don't destroy our own cover. Should hit and run this guy. We get one more shot. Will that flank him? Not sure. Let's see if we can get a flank on that guy. Not enough. Okay, he'll take the shot. Because we attacked. We will go into Overwatch.
We have eyes on the target. On task.
Xiaoji can take this guy out.
Target.
5 damage crit. Wow. Oh, we have Avenger, so we are actually excellent critical shooters. This guy on the open, I think our Rocketeer can take him out. Perfect.
I am ready.
We'll reload Xiaoji. If I clip this guy, I won't be able to reload. Let's go ahead and take this opportunity to reload.
Sergeant,
Move our operative up into striking range. Yeah, we can totally make it there. Reload. Steady aim with a rocket in case anyone moves up. Okay. That rocket is gonna pay dividends coming up. Van Dorn has a good shot. 60% chance to hit. No dice.
No joy here.
That medic has moved into the danger zone. We lucked out that they didn't want to take a shot at her. Yeah, you do not get much from Exalt. We're gonna land a rocket over there. And I think I might just let this new longbow rack up some kills. Oh, or not. His scatter has been brutal. That's fine. We do have a bunch of exposed targets, which our sniper will be happy to take out. Let's see which ones we have to leave for the sniper. Close encounters here. Let's wait on the next shot.
Yes, ma'am.
I think our scout can handle this one.
Head into that location.
That's
another dead alien.
That's not an alien, bruh. We got some blood, but it all missed. We should probably reload on her. Peek in range on that one. Go ahead and take the shot.
Drinks are on me.
Actually go into sniper overwatch here. Hunker. Reload. There's that sniper overwatch at those incredibly extended ranges. Oh, it was a good change. It was a good change. Admittedly, in vanilla, it was too much, but you got some serious choices now. Always with an Exalt dropping in way up top. Does he have bioelectric skin? He does. Can nobody see him up there? Oh, or am I detecting him with bioelectric skin? Seriously, dude, can you not nail this?
ракета пошла.
Like we can see that guy now. Should be able to draw his Overwatch, no? We'll expose these guys with explosives. If we can. Looks like we will let one out of the bag. And we'll empty our clip here.
Right in the kisser.
Maybe.
We disrupted the enemy communications network. It'll take some time for them to get it running again.
On the move.
This is one tough mother. We're gonna shift up here, nice safe flanking position thanks to the jump. Knock that one down to size.
Approaching target now.
I'm rolling.
We'll advance fire control Overwatch.
Weapons hot.
Reload. A steady weapon and hope for a hit and run shot next turn. We'll just pull back. This guy will probably do something dumb to try and get into the encoder space. Unless he panics and runs. Heals himself? That is a losing proposition versus my force. Whew! Impressive.
On the target.
Okay.
Scanning. Выхожу. Перезарядилась.
Caught a bit of a break. We can move the scout up because we've got the support.
Going there now. Reloading. I'm ready.
This guy. Just pull back so you don't hurt yourself. Okay, 25% chance to hit. 1 in 4, still not too bad to get a free shot. Ooh, that guy makes a poor placement. Uh-oh. Come on, Van Doren. Save. Save our friends. Well, it was looking like a poor... no one's nailing it. That was a 60% chance to hit. Another one? Okay, target-rich environment. A little bit of Overwatch. Okay, well, we can totally annihilate those guys. We need to kill this one up here, as he's in perfect grenade position. Perfect. And I've got one rocket left. Looks like we're only gonna get to use a rocket on one guy anyway. Let's just nail this guy. Very low scatter chance here. Did not destroy his cover, huh? Well, if we're lucky, Van Dorn's got his cover covered. We do have our command ability. Nothing. Thank you, Van Dorn. Van Dorn will give us a little bit of Overwatch coverage on the pit here. This frees up our sniper. So take a freebie shot here. The only exposed target we've got. And a little more brutal shot at one of these guys. Let's make Xiaoji a target. He does have will to survive and loads of armor. Oh, sadly. Let's see if he can nail this guy. Sadly, I thought we would get a hit and run shot from that. Okay, this is the one I would be worried about flanking us. So let's pare him down a bit. Apply some of that fog. This one, we've got two shotgun shots. If the first one crits, the second one should kill. Do burn through ammo that way, but we don't die. Not gonna get there. A little bit of Overwatch. If they shoot us, it's fine. That's not a super experienced covert operative. I believe it's just a specialist assault. Okay, with the low mobility, someone's probably gonna take him out. Nice. Pistol Overwatch. I did lower pistol Overwatch range to be more like shotguns, so it'd be more worthwhile. Our scout definitely didn't want our scout hit, but not as worried about that. All right, Xiaoji, he's got this one. Just like killing a man.
That's it, Commander. The transmitter is secure. It looks like that was the last of Exalt's forces in the area. Excellent work.
Alright, we did get a nick on our shiny new Rocketeer, but Operation Unceasing Spark, we brought the pain. That pit is a great place, as long as you don't lose that first secure spot, so you need someone who can get down in there and not die. And the slight wound puts him at only 5 days, so we have someone else who's all Van Dorn also is 5 days. So we really lucked out on the wound roll here. It is a little randomized how long it'll take. The more wounds, the worse it is. And 270 credits and panic reduction. When they say by one, they actually mean by 20 out of the 100. It means one on the 5-point scale, but since we're using 100-point scale, that's 20 points each. And we earn some bonus credit. 3 meld. You get those from killing Exalt. If you kill too many with explosives, you won't get the meld, but hey. The Advanced Exalt are actually decent sources of meld.
The intel we recovered was enough to take down the rest of Exalt's cell. Unfortunately, looks like this was just a small part of their wider reaching clandestine operation. We did manage to find some clues.
Okay, 270 credits plus the council report should give us plenty to buy beam weapons.
We'll be able to narrow down the possibilities and take out Exalt once and for all.
He's telling us that the more of these missions we go on, the more we know about where Exalt is and isn't. Should do a scan. We should do a scan at the end of this month, because every month actually resets the scan cost. Note the scan is extra cheap because we are France, and part of our bonus is that intel scans are 40% cheaper. So, since this cost will reset, I like scanning at the end of the month is cheap.
Intel scan complete. Positive ID on Exalt cell location.
And we locate an Exalt cell location. And note that the scan cost will go down in 2 days, so we'll reset, that is, because it gets more and more expensive. So who do we have that we wouldn't mind sending out? Rebecca Blake. Rebecca Blake, why are you so special? Are you... I'll have to watch my own video to figure out why I marked her. Well, she's fast, has good aim. Oh, she's a covert op. That's where we're going with this. Okay. Might be a little early. I think you have 2 or 3 days to launch your covert op. She is fast and available. Everything I like in a covert operative. Well, we do have hit and run. We do have an excellent assault covert op here. We can go holo targeting, which is always great with hit and run. It kind of guarantees that someone else will be able to nail that if you don't kill the target instantly. If we're thinking covert operative here, Sprinter is an excellent choice, although we are incredibly fast already. And of course, Avenger would just be incredible. So let's gear this assault. Let's gear this assault towards covert operations, because we will need a couple people to go on them, and the chances are you can lose someone pretty easily. Plus the high base health of assaults and will to survive make for excellent low equipment survivable soldiers. So I'm just gonna and she is ready to go. Wait, I mean she will be ready to go, right? Eleven hours. Yeah. Okay. We're not gonna wait. We're gonna go on the next mission. I'm going to record that right now. And yeah. Alright, that's enough for this episode. Thanks for watching. And until next time, play on, players.